What is up, you guys? Thank you so much for being a part of my channel. I really and truly appreciate each and every one of you. Don't forget to like the video, share, and subscribe to the channel. If you would like more exclusive content, follow us onto Patreon. I have also opened the memberships back up so you have access to the extended videos, as well as being able to book personals with me. Don't forget, all that is listed in the description box. What is up, you guys? Thank you so much for being a part of my channel. I really and truly appreciate each and every one of you guys. We are going to do an energy read for this next 24. What you need to know, what you need to be aware of, and what you can expect. Look, let's go with the Psychic Tarot Oracle deck to see what the energies are around you in this next 24, okay? What are the energies around them in the next 24? Spirit, please come through, okay? This looks like a lot of creative energy for some of you in this next 24. You're going to feel the need, I heard, to be reclusive, okay? So, to pull back from certain people, places, and events that may make you feel uneasy or take away your peace, okay? I feel like things are happening for you. What you don't see, okay, some of you may see it, but what some of you don't see is that you are in the prime energy right now for manifestation. You are in the prime energy to have things go your way if you set your sights on what it is that you want right now, okay? For some of you, this reclusive energy is definitely going to benefit you, all right? I feel like it's like anything that is taking away your peace or pushing you into a place where you're feeling combative, you are learning to... It's like working around certain situations possibly better than you did before. You're not allowing anybody to kind of shake you or like take you from a place where you feel like you can think before you respond. Okay. Let's see what your environment energy is though. What's the environment energy? The people who are around you. What's that energy looking like? Look. And then I said what I said. Okay, so they said what they said. All right. Okay, financial and material changes. Okay, so for some of you, you have been needing to pull some of your creative energy back for yourself, using some for you. Okay, that's going back to that depleted energy that you're trying to keep from happening to you. I heard again, so it may have already happened. I feel that we've got something going on with your energy where people are wanting your time, energy, and resources, but I feel like they're at a loss in this time. It's like people possibly trying to grab for something that's yours, grabbing for something that you have, and it's like, no, no, I'm not going to say that. I feel like my, I heard Leroy. Okay, so I have an ancestor on my black side that I just recognized who he is. Like, I don't know him because I don't know that biological side, that blood side, but he's coming through saying, nah, nigga, nah. Okay, so this is somebody who is definitely, there's somebody in your environment who is trying to come for what it is that you have, but it's like they don't recognize that you are trying to operate from a place of peace, y'all. This person doesn't, it's like they're not looking at it like that. They're looking at it, why do you have what you have and I ain't got shit over here? Okay, that's a you problem. I heard that's a them problem. Okay, so for some of you, you're going to notice some kind of success coming through for you. You're about to start being propelled out of an energy, propelled away from certain people who still want to have some kind of grab or hold on your time. But it's like, I feel like you're recognizing in this time that you can do as you please. You can do what you want. This person is no longer holding you back. This is something about setting your sights clear for a broader horizon or having more of the things that you've hoped and dreamed for, okay? You have just recently overcome some kind of major burden or major mountain. I heard a milestone. You've completed some kind of major milestone in your life. Congratulations. Also, I know I haven't said it, but happy Gemini season. Happy birthday, y'all, for everybody that I haven't, you know, told y'all happy birthday. I need to start doing that, but you know, I'm a Sagittarius. I'm all over the damn place. Anyway, so back to you. Accelerated motion. There's something that's speeding up for you in this time. You're overcoming major obstacles, and I don't feel like you're not seeing it. I feel like you are seeing it, but you're kind of like, damn, I just wish it could have been a different way. I wish it could have went this way. You know, I feel like there's something going on with this person who's trying to grab on your time, though. For some of y'all ain't gonna want me to look into it, but for others of you, I'm probably gonna do it anyway. First, we're gonna stick with y'all, though. Okay, so we see that your creative energy is starting to soar and pick up. That's also your sexual, her pleasure. For some of y'all, you may have been abstaining from sexual relations. Okay. I feel like for some of you, you may have been keeping, I heard, you may have been keeping your legs closed. Okay. I feel like that has done something for you and is amplifying your power in this time. Specifically, the power that you have to manifest. There has been somebody depleting you. Okay. So in your environment, you may have somebody who has a hard time keeping their hands off of you. Also in your environment, I feel like you are kind of pulling away from this individual, wanting more space for you, wanting more space for yourself, your thoughts, to keep your peace. You don't want somebody to come in and take that. It's almost like there may be a certain person that you hook up with. I don't know if you hook up with them from time to time or what the hell this is. But for some of you, you know what I'm talking about, okay? This person may be trying to reach out to you in this next little while, but it's like, I feel like you are out of reach. For some of you, I heard you can miss me with that, and you are talking about changing your number. If you have been feeling the need to change your number, I suggest that you do it. If this is somebody that you have to co-parent with, don't get your ass in trouble. Get you a co-parenting app, because I feel like this could be someone here who is like a psychic vampire. It's like they drain you of your energy, okay? Drain you in more than one way, okay? It's like the second that you get off with this person, it's like your manifestation powers are depleted, or there's something about this person is a psychic vampire. I feel like some of you have come to recognize this, and it's like you're recognizing that you are either stronger alone or you can do more for yourself. They start playing flowers. I can buy my own flowers, write my name in the sand, talk to myself for hours, say things you don't understand. I can take myself dancing. Okay, so that's y'all's song. Okay, that's y'all's channel song for next 24. You're recognizing that, okay, I can love me better than you can. Okay, thank you. Eventually it comes through. All right, so some of you are recognizing that you can love yourself better than a specific individual who wants to connect themselves to you. But it's like every time you connect to this person, you know what happens to you. You know how you start feeling, okay? There does need to be some kind of barrier between you and this individual, okay? So if you've been feeling like you need to change your number, please, by all means, change your number, all right? You can still be in communication with somebody for, you know, if it's a parenting situation, you got like legal, you've got to talk to this person legally, get you a co-parenting app in place. It's going to be the best. You're welcome. It's the best thing you would have ever done for yourself. Okay. It's like that somehow helps you separate your energy from this person to where they cannot drain you the way that they have previously. Okay. I guess some of y'all need to hear that too, especially with that sacral chakra. That could definitely be, you know, we're talking about, I thought say sexual organs, sexual energy, creative energy, creating creations. Okay. So anyways, let's see. What is your day looking like? What's the next 24 looking like besides pulling back? You are starting to invest into yourself. For some of you, maybe taking up some kind of, I about said sport. Gardening is not a sport. Gardening is not a sport, but I see gardening, but I heard sport. So, for some of you, maybe taking up sports, okay, getting more active, getting more involved, because I feel like there's something about sweaty. I'm getting a lot of sweaty energy coming through. That can also come through in regards to that, okay? For some of you, if you have recently hooked up with this person, you're going to start feeling very depleted, okay? And it's going to click. Look, you see me about flip my clipboard over? It's going to click with you. Okay. Oh, okay. So when I hook up with this person, I no longer have any energy to do anything for me. I have no energy to do anything for, you know, all the things that I want to do. It's like they zap me. They do that shit on purpose. They want you to be sitting around waiting on them in that energy. Okay, take that for what you will. But I definitely see this next 24 hours. It looks like you are taking the time out. This is practicing patience, being patient with your energy level, and it looks like you're recouping something. For some of you, you could be recouping some cash that maybe you have squandered is the word that I'm hearing. Okay, you may have squandered some cash. Okay, whatever, whatever. I feel like it's like certain expenses that may have come up for you that you may have had to drop some money on. But it's crazy. You got it, though. You got it to drop. Okay, but I feel like you've also got this cash to drop because of the energy that you have taken to remove yourself from either a certain group of people that constantly leave you depleted. That financial and material changes is usually lost, y'all. Okay. And it's giving Five of Pentacles. There's somebody here who definitely needs, is coming back for a second chance in order to try to recoup some kind of financial situation, recoup some kind of energy from, take some energy from you or take some money from you. Okay. Let's just be real. Okay. Let's say it for what it is. And I feel like you are recognizing in this time where your time, energy, and resources are better spent, okay? With this Chariot card, that could also be court processes for some of you. There's something about processing time. I'm hearing processing time for something that you're trying to create, okay? I feel like for those of you who have been wanting something specific, I heard you're getting on my nerves, all right? Somebody may be getting on your nerves with certain proceedings. It may be getting on your nerves because of the finances that you are losing out on. I feel like this person feels like if they keep on grabbing for your energy, they will eventually get wish fulfillment. I feel like this is also why you're pulling back. All right. This is also somebody trying to show up. Okay. Showing up out of the blue because you actually have something that they want. Okay. Let's see the energy between you and this person. Next actions from this person towards you. Look, they see that you have things that they want. Their next energy is towards you. Eight of Pentacles, working on something, and closure of the world. Okay, so I feel like there's something that you're doing in this time that they feel like they are on the outskirts of. All right, justice came up again, so that's also court proceedings. Okay, so that's weighing heavily on somebody's mind. All right, I feel like this person feels like if they continue to put in work, time, energy, and resources, they can bring something to completion in more of a positive manner, okay? I feel like they know that something is being observed and something is being looked at heavily, okay? This is somebody here who you're dealing with trying to close out this energy between the two of you that you're actually having to pay attention to what it is that you're saying because there's something being documented or something being recorded, okay? It's like wanting a new contract, wanting a new offer to come in, and the only way that you can get this is to pull back, okay? This could have been a tactic that this person used on you previously, but I feel like there's something about the way that you've come through. You've perfected this energy, and I feel like because you've done this, you are going to be getting some kind of wish fulfillment, okay? You're getting wish fulfillment from kind of like starving an energy vampire, all right? Removing your emotions, removing what it is that you can create from this person. For some of y'all, you're very, like there's something about your manifestation gift, your manifestation power. This person, when they were able to attach to you, okay, however they were attaching to you, they were able to flip that energy and use it. And you're coming into that knowledge, okay? It's like you may have been open to sharing with this person at one point in time. I feel like you're just like, no. Like you're recognizing that this person, it's like they will use you until they've used you up or use you until that you run dry and you're not cool with it. Okay. I feel like you are pulling your emotions back from this person or you're making this active decision to pull your emotions back and put into yourself. There's something that you're wanting to cultivate or grow. I see that you are starting to actually see traction in that and they're still showing me gardening. Make sure that you look, I told you sweat. Like, I feel like there's something going on with, You sweating, or maybe they're saying that would be good for you to sweat in this time in order to release some of this pent up emotions. Okay, there's something about that. Okay, maybe you are going to be taking up some kind of sport, like they said, or some kind of physical activity that's going to help you through this energy that you're working through, as far as like pulling back your emotions from this person, pulling back your energy from this person, and putting it into yourself. There's something about building yourself back up. All right. And I feel like this is talking about not only energetically building yourself back up, but they're talking about building yourself back. I don't know if this is building muscle tone. It's your body. Okay. It's like building your body back up. Okay. I feel like there's a reason and a season. I feel like a cycle has completed between you and this person. Okay, yeah, and then my right palm just started itching. So there's going to be some kind of finances that you recoup after the situation, because I feel like somebody may have actually taken, like they've already taken something from you. We've established that they have taken something from you. And it's like you are definitely in the mode of making sure that they can no longer do this. And I feel like there are certain paperwork or documents that you need to stay on top of. Okay, but I feel like you don't need to let it consume you too much, because I feel like too much of your emotional state focused on them papers is going to make you more reclusive than you even want to be.